Hi Jim, recently back on a video of CATIA V5, and in this video I will show you how to design this particular part on the right hand side, as you can see. And this is going to be part 8 of Practice Beginner series. So let's get started. So first of all, I click on new, go to part, name it as part 8. Alright, so we can see that okay, this is a simple part, it's not that hard. But it consists of a stiffener. So that will be something new that we are going to use. Before that, other than that, I mean, it's nothing that complex, just a simple shape. So I will start mainly with just the base from the top view. I can start from the top view right here. Right? I like working in isometric, as you guys would have seen so far. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a oriented rectangle, which is also basically a 3-point rectangle, right? So now I know I do have an idea where to work. Now I'm simply going to use an arc, or I could have simply used it before as well. It looks like it's tangent to the thing, so I'm simply going to make it tangent. And how do I know it? So this length is 60 right here, and the radius is 30. So it has to be tangent anyways. I'm going to make this as construction element because that will be a problem later on. So this parallel, I'm just going to move it around. Now I can simply dimension if I want, but also I can make the cut if I want to. So that's basically a slot shape. So I can look for a slot. There would be up-round, elongated hole right here, something like that. I have to make sure that it coincides with the center. So coincide. I can give the dimensions now finally. So this whole circle is, the radius is 20, so this is 20. The whole thing. Oh, not the half. Half is going to be 10, right? As you can see, 20 right here. So I'm going to dimension the other parameters as well. So the hole is, entire thickness is 60. This way, and it's symmetrical. So 30 on this side and 30 there. Looks good. Then how much is the distance in total? So 75 from the base. So starting from here till the beginning of here. So this is 75. There we go. So rest, it doesn't even matter, to be honest. Now I need to make sure that where does this thing coincides. So similarly, it looks like that it coincide at the tangent as well. So what I mean is this point and this line are going to be coinciding as well. That's what it looks like. And I'm pretty sure that I'm right. I'm just going to extend it because that really doesn't matter. I'm just going to eliminate these lines anyways. Right? I just got rid of those lines. If I want to dimension them back again, I can. Not a big deal. So it says that okay, it's moving. It's moving because it's not horizontal. That's why. So I made it horizontal. So now I can get rid of these two lines as well. I'm going to trim it, trim this as well. So I got the extrude surface that I need. I'm going to exit out. I'm going to click on pad. So the thickness I need is what, 15 it says. So I'm going to extrude or pad it for 15. There we go. Looks like a pear shape. So we have this in our isometric. That's what we wanted. So now I can also make a particular wall shape right here. I'm just going to sketch it. And I can simply, if I want, I can simply take the reference. Reference of the baseline. Click OK. I'm going to make mainly a straight wall, nothing special about it. I'm just going to make three connections. Three lines connected all together. I'm going to dimension it. So I know that it's 65 from the top and 65 from here till there. So this is going to be 65. And yeah, that looks fine. And I have to pad it towards, not this side, I have to reverse the direction because I've already added 75 to it. So this thickness is 15 as well. So I'm going to click OK. Looks fine. So that's the maximum length. And I need to make this circle now underneath it. So I can make that feature as well. So what I'm going to do is, I know that is semicircle. So I'm just going to project this line right here. And I'm going to make two circles right in the middle, one, and this is going to be the second one. There we go. And I can dimension it. One is going to be 30 and one is, and the other one is 15. So one is 30 in diameter. Okay, that was very close. All right, I'm just going to, so one is going to be 30. The middle one is going to be 30. So let's say this is 30. All right. And the other one is 15 and 15 more. So it means that this is going to be 30 and thickness of 15 on the side. So basically you can say that, okay, it's going to be half of it. So we have 15 and 15, 30. So 60 in total. So that's the whole circle itself. Alright, so these are the lines that we would need. I can trim all the extra lines that I don't need, which is these two right here. It's showing an error because it says that it's basically tangent, which is true as well. I need to get rid of this extra line and that would be fine. I just need to extrude it or pad it towards this side. I don't need to worry much about anything else. I'm just going to pad it and I'm going to pad it towards me. So what do I mean is, I can simply say that, so this whole thickness is 50. I know this thickness is 15. So I have to write 50 minus 15, which is 35. I can simply write that I will only pad it till 35. But I have this shape that I don't need. So I can simply click pocket and click on this shape, right? Reverse direction, click OK. There we go. It was a simple step. Sometimes it's hard to understand. So you can also choose pocket. So let me show you once again what I did. So I chose pocket because I already know that what I need to eliminate. And instead of making and taking it as a reference, if you simply click on it, it says you have selected a surface as profile. You must specify a direction of extrusion. Do you want to define it? You click on yes, and you can see that you have to click there once again, and it will automatically snap the entire profile. Reverse direction because you want to cut on the other side, and click OK. There we go. So we are almost there. So this is the only thing that is left, that's the stiffener itself. We can see it's a stiffener of 10 right in the middle from 25. So if we do quick maths, so 25 on each side is going to be 50 plus thickness of 10. So it's right in the middle. So we can use the plane if we want to. Just a second. As we can see that we have this plane that we are going to use right in the middle. I'm going to sketch here, just one particular line, nothing much. I can simply project this surface right in front and this particular surface right at the bottom. And I can make them as construction element, right? And I will make just one line, nothing much, from here till the base. That's all. I'm going to exit out. And I'm going to click on stiffener right here. Next to combine solid, it says stiffener. I will increase. So it says invalid profile. Oh, I see. Okay. That makes sense. I need to make this as a reference, not that. Let me try once again. Let me try once again, once again. It should work. Sometimes it doesn't for some reason. I also don't understand that. Very weird. So it's fixed. Where is it moving from? Stiffener, stiffener, stiffener. It says invalid. What about from top? Yeah. From side. Okay, it says invalid profile. I need to have a flow direction, I know that for sure. Interesting. This thing is not working. Let me try another way of making it. So I can just extrude it if I want to. So this is going to be non-construction element because I don't want this to be construction. So click OK. Make this as a projection. So this I'm going to simply project it. Construction element right here. That's very interesting. It's coming out to be this way. And what about this end? What about this end? What about this end? Okay, it's not working this way. Right here, till here. Right here. Okay. It shows it's fully defined, but it's still not giving me the option to use the stiffener feature. Invalid profile. If that's happening, you can simply close the sketch as well. Not that big of a deal. You already know where to start and end from. Simply come here and close the entire profile. Drag it out. Stiffener. You must use an open profile for the feature you want to create. Well, I was already using it, not showing me the feature that I was trying to make from. Okay. Well, again, I mean, they're asking us to keep it open, but they don't want us to keep it open as well, which is a weird combination. Let's say I just let it be open at this particular phase. And again, showing that, okay, it's not possible. So that's very weird. Sometimes it just starts showing error, which I don't even understand sometimes. So it's better to just make a shape and just extrude it rather than giving it too much of attention. So simply make a sketch of triangle, any triangle, because we know that we already have enough material here, so we don't need to care much about it. So I can simply project the front, which is going to be my limit. At least I know that, okay, I'm not going to extend beyond this. And I will simply start from here, then till here, till the base, which is my origin of this part. I zoom in origin and then anywhere here. Perfect. All right. So now I can place this point of contact right here to come all the way here. Go inside. There we go. If nothing else work, I will just simply make my pad work instead of anything else. That's the beauty about engineering. If things that don't go your way, you can just make whatever you think is the best way itself. So this, I can simply trim off extra lines which I don't need. This, 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 and this, and this as well. I don't need it. I do know that that is extra. I can simply pad it, right? I don't need to do so much of headache. I can do mirror extent and of 5. So basically, both sides 5. I can add thickness. That's it. That's pretty much it. So yeah, sometimes things are not going to work as you thought. Just like stiffener was not working for me today. I will try to figure out what was the problem and come up with the solution. But once again, we got what we wanted and we should be respectful for that. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you like it. Although it was sort of challenging, it got at the end, but it was fun as well. So I hope you like it. If you have any questions, you can ask me in the comment section. I would love to answer them. And once again, take it easy. Take care. Bye.